Hey everyone, it's Craig here with another Blu-ray review. This time I'm looking at Marvel's Black Panther, which is now available on 4K Blu-ray and digitally. So if you were living under a rock for most of 2018, then you probably didn't hear about Black Panther, but it's one of the biggest movies of the year so far. The only thing that it has been outdone by so far is another Marvel ditty called Avengers Infinity War. But yeah, Black Panther was an amazing movie. It was just beloved by basically anyone who took the time to go see it. It is definitely something that you should check out if you haven't before. So if you saw the movie in theaters, chances are you are going out and buying it almost immediately, or waiting for that special holiday or birthday or whatever have you, or a sale, maybe even that. And if you didn't see it in theaters and you're still on the fence about whether or not to pick it up, I actually highly recommend it. It's definitely an entertaining movie, one of Marvel's most different movies, completely. And it's, of course, it looks and sounds great on Blu-ray. I haven't seen the 4K copy, but I've heard amazing things about it, and I just highly recommend it for that. I also am a snob, of course, as you know from other Blu-ray reviews. I like to, that just all blended together, Blu-ray reviews. I like to look at the special features that are also included, and I will say, though, in this regards for the Black Panther, I am a little bit disappointed. A lot of the special features just weren't really my speed. There were four behind-the-scenes looks at the making of the film. That included one where it talked about the world of Black Panther, all the complexities in it. There was one that was talking about the Wakandan women, which I really loved that. And then there was one talking about all the different diverse people in Wakanda, the different tribes that they have in there. And then also there was one that focused on the technology, which, it gave a little bit of a look into the making of the movie, but just not enough for my taste. I like a lot of behind the scenes looks at the actual filming of it. So these weren't quite for me, but I think for the average enthusiast, they'll be pretty good. There was actually a really cool roundtable discussion that was called From the Page to the Screen, because it featured some of the people who have written Black Panther comics, as well as then Ryan Coogler and the screenwriter for Black Panther all together, and talking about how they really adapted the movie. It's a good long discussion, and definitely one of the standout features on it. It's very, very interesting. Of course, there's deleted scenes. I don't believe any of them really added to the enjoyment of the movie. So if you like deleted scenes, they are available for you. Of course, there is a gag reel as well, too. And I dislike gag reels, so this one didn't do anything for me. It's just so short. It's all inside jokes, which, as a person who makes a lot of inside jokes, I should be in love with gag reels. But I wasn't impressed with this one. Then, other two to mention, there was a sneak peek at the Ant-Man and the Wasp, which will be coming out very soon. Sorry, not the Ant-Man and Wasp. I'm just screwing that up. Ant-Man and the Wasp, and I actually really enjoyed watching that. It didn't give away too much more about the upcoming movie, but I think just enough to whet our appetites for it. And then another Marvel Studios in the first 10 years, connecting the universe. Just amazing. I know they've done already at least one Marvel Studios in the first 10 years looking at that. I hope this is all part of a bigger documentary one day that they're putting together about this whole first 10 years of Marvel, because it's some great content that pulls in from all the different movies in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. So I also really love this one. The director's commentary is available as well, too. This one didn't really keep me captivated for very long. So I'll be honest, I ended up turning off the commentary track after about 20 or 30 minutes. It didn't really have a lot of flow to it. It's the kind of commentary track that I'm not really a fan of, where it's just like little bits and pieces of, oh yeah, when we made this, we ran into this issue. And I like a little bit more liveliness out of it. If it's not going to be super intriguing, it should be a big discussion with a lot of people on the making of it. And so this one just didn't do it for me. But there were also two special features that were digital exclusives, and these were Wakanda tourism ads, and these were actually fantastic. So the second you get Black Panther, if you get it on 4K or Blu-ray, go ahead and make sure you use your code that you get in there for Disney Movie Rewards and Movies Anywhere, and go ahead and redeem it so you can see these, because they were pretty neat, and you need to get your Disney Movie Rewards points. So overall, special features, I'm not really a fan of them, but I still think you should go out there and get this, because the Blu-ray on its own just really holds up. So the movie for me doesn't have a lot of repeat value at this point, like watching it back to back, but this is one that I know I will watch again probably at least once a year for as long as I own it. So I do highly recommend going out and getting it. And that is it for this Blu-ray review. So I'll be back with you in the future for another one, I'm sure. But until then, hope you enjoy the movie, and goodbye.